dust. It is everywhere, so we may as well just embrace it and use it as realism in our renders. So, I made a dust generator that does exactly that. You can drag and drop it, and it adds a nice layer of dust on top of any object you use. Now, if you like dust in Blender, leave a like, comment, subscribe, and hit that little bell, because in the next video I will show you how to create a floating dust particle system that looks incredible in some nice lighting. Now, there's two versions of this drag and drop dust generator. There's one that's gonna be free, it's a demo. You can drag and drop it and it will add dust, and you can change the scale of your dust system. Right, in the other version, the premium version, you can tweak whatever settings I will show you later. There's a huge bunch of settings and you can tweak it to your own personal preferences. You can get the free demo version from within the Blender Universe Asset Library plugin, download it below, and you can get that from within the asset browser and the BU Asset Library core is what we call it, and you will have the geometry node setups right there. Now you can just drag and drop Dustify on top there, and it will add that layer of dust on top of your objects, pretty much, right? So you'll be limited there to the density and scale customization options, and the rest will be part of the premium. Okay, that will also be added later to the premium section of the Blender Universe add-on. So how do you get the premium version? Well, you can wait for the premium version of the Blender Universe and play with the demo up to that point. We're gonna be releasing the premium version very soon, but if you want it right now, you can also get it from my Gumroad page, right, which will be the blend file that contains the geometry setup and the shader. Right, and to get it into your scene after you download the .blend file is by going to File, Append, locate the .blend file, go to Node 3 and then Append Dustify and the NG Dustify. NG stands for Node Group. Right, so append these two and go back to your blend file. Right, then back in your scene, you can select the object that you want to add Dustify to, go to the Modifier panel, Add Modifier, Geometry Nodes, and set this to be Dustify. There we go. Now you'll get the dust on top of your object, and you'll get all the customization options, right? Now to add a material group, we can go and select our object, go to the Shader Editor, there we go, and now let's say we want to add it to, well, the original material of this object, material.002, and we want to add that node group that we just, well, appended in between the principal BSDF or any kind of BSDF and the material output. Just make sure to add it just before the output, right? So hit Shift A and look for the group, and then we're going to go into the NG Dustify, and then we can just drag that in between. Right, and once you have that added, you'll end up with something like this, right? And it depends on your object, right? You may have to tweak some of these values to get the results you want, especially the edge radius, for example, depends on the scale of your object as well. So play around with that. And, well, there you go. This is going to be the actual material, right? Completely customizable. We can tweak the color of the dirt, for example, if that's something we'd like. The dirt strength amounts, right? We can really add some thick layers of dirt on there, or even mold, it looks like, right? If we crank up this roughness, there we go. And the bump strength, we almost get like a layer of thick mold on top. Maybe something you like, but if not, crank that down. And well, the rest of this really speaks for itself. We have the edge wear section, the fingerprint section, the dirt section, and the dust haze section, which adds that little layer of white haze on top, right? So if I remove this again, you can see it's very clean, very saturated, and it looks very new. And if I Ctrl Z, that will have our actual Dustify back, right? And it looks much more in line with the actual dust on top, right? So if I crank up this density of the dust now to, let's say, 3, and the top distribution to like 0.4, we get like a very nice dusty look here, right? So this is something that actually looks like it has been sitting on your desk or in your basement for quite a while, right? So something I like to play around with myself is the actual hair section here. We have a short hair and a long hair version. For example, when you have a little pet like this guy here in your house, you may want some shorter hairs, even though this one is quite long-haired. And we may want a combination of long and short hair in our system, right? So that is something I added and something I like to play around with. So the hair length, we can make that longer, the densities as well, right? We can crank that up and you'll get more of those hairs. And we can make it shorter, we can tweak the noise, skill, strength, we can tweak the material of the hairs. Now for the long hairs as well, increase the density, we'll get more of those longer hairs. And we can even crank up the density of that one to get more of those long hairs, or make them even longer if you'd like really long hairs, right? They'll be sticking a bit out of your surface. And I even added an option that has pretty much, well, this is maybe a little bit too long, let's decrease it a little bit, that will stick your hairs out of your objects a little bit more, right? So you can see that this pointy bit of your hair will stick out a bit more. And we can tweak that value, right? We can make it stick out even more. And that is something that can look incredibly nice under the right lighting circumstances, right? So if I go to rendered view here, and let's see if we can find a section that I'm talking about here. All right, so let's zoom in a place where we have some hair sticking out. For example, I see one right here. All right, so we will actually get that hair sticking out and then get some very nice close-up results for your dust system as well, right? Add some really nice hairs there on top, get some nice details with it as well. All right, so that is something I like to play around with. I added a material option for both as well. I set them to white by default just because it's the easiest kind of hair to have in your scenes. But you can also just tweak the color to be anything else than white. You can make it brown, you can make it yellow, blonde, black, you can make it orange, whatever kind of color you're looking for. For example, if you have a little orange cat in your house, you can just tweak the hairs to be orange. Oh my god, this little fellow is going a little bit wild. Let's get rid of him for a sec. And then we can tweak that to be an orange hair that matches your cat perfectly, right? So that is going to be nice and customizable. Now the last thing we have is hair thickness, right? If you want thicker hairs, you can make that happen. If you want thinner hairs, you can make that happen too. And the smooth hair one, right? So if you have it from more of a distance, you can save yourself some performance by just unchecking this smooth hair, right? And that means your hairs will basically be lower resolution, and that is going to be beneficial for your system's performance, of course, right? So that is something that you may have to keep in mind that is active at the default setting. Okay, beautiful. So I think we covered everything, and well, I hope that you like this. I hope you can use this for some nice close-up details in your scene. And if you did like it, please leave a like, a comment, subscribe, hit that little bell, and then I'd love to see you in the next one. Thank you and bye.